In the next couple of minutes, we will present how visualization in computational geometry can support theory work. Our case study is the approximation of the medial axis in the plane. Our input is a set of sample points on the boundary of a smooth shape. The goal is to approximate the medial axis. To do this, first we approximate the shape with a union of balls, then we compute the exact medial axis of this union. Let's see how it works. As a first step, we compute the Voronoi diagram of the sample points. Then, we identify the inner Voronoi vertices. The identification algorithm is a variant of the power crust algorithm designed by Amenta, Choi and Kaluri. Every Voronoi vertex corresponds to a Voronoi circle, and the union of the corresponding disks gives an approximation of our shape. Attali has proven that the medial axis of a union of balls has a relatively simple structure, and later Amenta and Kaluri designed an algorithm to efficiently compute this medial axis. We are going to present how this algorithm works. To start, we first have to compute the dual of the union of balls, a structure introduced by Ederspruner. Let's take a look at a smaller example to show how it can be computed. First, we compute the power diagram of the weighted points represented by the balls. Now consider the power diagram restricted to this union. The dual of the restricted power diagram is the dual of the balls. For every edge in the restricted power diagram, we add an edge between the corresponding ball centers, and for every vertex in the restricted power diagram, we add the triangle constructed by the corresponding ball centers. Finally, this is the dual of the balls. Now let us return to our original example. In order to compute the medial axis, we have to identify the intersection points of the balls which lie on the boundary of the union. We will call them V points throughout this video. As proven by Attali, the medial axis of the union of balls is the intersection of the dual and the Voronoi diagram of the V points. This is the final result, the medial axis of the union of inner Voronoi balls. What are the drawbacks of this approach? Since our balls are Voronoi balls, they have a very specific configuration. They are in a degenerate position by construction. Notice how dozens of circles intersect in one single point in this example. This setting leads to numeric instabilities if imprecise floating point arithmetic is used. Actually, the final result of the medial axis would look like this with the usual floating point arithmetic. All the results shown before were computed with the exact arithmetic provided by the core library. Wouldn't it be great if we could compute the same medial axis approximation faster and more robustly? Let's take a look again at our results. Now blend in the Voronoi diagram of the samples. Notice how the Voronoi diagram overlaps the medial axis approximation. Attali has suggested that the inner Voronoi diagram can be interpreted as the medial axis of the union of balls. Our illustration perfectly matches her observation. Why does this happen? Let's take a look again at the V points. Remember, they are the intersections of the balls which lie on the boundary of the union. Notice that all V points are sample points as well. But a couple of sample points are not V points. These correspond actually to the endpoints of the medial axis. Is this true in general, or was this just a coincidence? Let's take a look at some more shapes with denser sampling. We have visualized that the interpretation of Attali nicely holds. Moreover, we pointed out that the V points are a subset of the sample points. This observation can be used as an intermediary step in a formal proof that the medial axis of the inner Voronoi balls is exactly the inner Voronoi diagram. Does this mean that the problem of finding a useful skeleton can be solved simply by using the inner Voronoi diagram? Unfortunately not. First of all, these results do not extend to shapes in 3 dimensions, and even in 2 dimensions, there are shortcomings of the medial axis. The most important problem is the instability of the medial axis. This means that a small change on the surface might induce a large change in the medial axis. To illustrate this, we will consider this shape sampled by a set of noisy points and apply a simple Laplacian smoothing on the boundary. Notice how the boundary smoothing results only in minor changes in the shape. On the other hand, the dual of the balls changes dramatically under the same smoothing. Similarly, the distribution of the Voronoi vertices is very sensitive to the noise on the boundary. And as mentioned before, the medial axis of the shape is very unstable under small changes on the surface. How can we interactively visualize such structures and create these illustrations? Our tool called Messicina leverages the flexibility of Seagull for geometry computation and uses OpenGL for high-quality, efficient rendering. Let's take a look in fast forward at the user experience in Messicina.